Fly 8 gives us a bird's eye view of a growing problem in the Willamette River. See all that bright green? That's a blue-green algae bloom in the Ross Island Lagoon.
And as you can see, it's the color of green that resembles the Chicago River on St. Patrick's Day.
Willie Levinson with the Human Access Project has been monitoring its growth for days.
The harmful algae bloom has been spotted as far down as St. John's in varying degrees. The largest concentration by far is in the Ross Island Lagoon.
This week, the Oregon Department of Environmental Quality took samples of the algae. Results showed toxins below harmful levels for people, but samples did show levels that could be harmful to dogs.
Human Access Project, this has been our number one priority since 2015.
This is video of that bloom back in 2015. Levinson says it was that summer he realized these kinds of blooms would become more common with warming river temperatures.
The good news is that there is a solution to this problem.
Since then, agencies have been researching ways to stop the blooms from happening.
So what our strategies have focused on is really moving the water around.
Desiree Tullis is a professor of river engineering at Oregon State University. She says using pumps to bring cold water from the bottom of the lagoon up to the surface could be a short-term solution. A longer-term solution would be to let the river flow freely through the area.
But if we can sort of create an opening through it and actually a flow moving through the lagoon again, that also is, the model suggests, could be effective.
Tullis says finding a solution is the first step. The next step will be to find funding for it, because these folks say something needs to be done.
These kinds of years are going to become the norm. We've seen it happening over the last 5 years. The bloom is not going to go away.
The Oregon Health Authority and the Department of Environmental Quality will monitor the bloom to see if it does grow. They expect to do additional testing in the next couple of weeks. Keely Chalmers, KGW News.